The development of novel sensing technologies represents a key asset for healthcare, safety, and security not only in Europe, but all around the world. With the aging population, cheap diagnostic systems and personalized point-of-care solutions could significantly help reduce healthcare costs. Moreover, the detection of potentially harmful substances in the environment is vital to the prevention of pollution, toxic substances in food and atmosphere, biohazard threats, and terrorist attacks. One of the most sensitive techniques to detect the presence of specific molecules in the environment exploits their so-called vibrational fingerprint. Each molecule is constituted by atoms bonded together, and each bond has a characteristic frequency or vibration. Infrared light allows us to directly induce such vibrations by simply illuminating the substance. Therefore, an infrared spectrum carries very specific information that uniquely characterizes each molecule and can be employed to recognize it. Unfortunately, as the concentration of the molecules goes down, their detection by means of infrared light becomes increasingly difficult. Gemini tackles this issue by employing nano-antennas. The project has been financed by the 7th Framework Program of the European Union under the call for future and emerging technologies. As much as the large television antennas on our roofs capture the electromagnetic radiation and feed it into a wire, nano antennas are microscopic objects that capture the infrared light, which is also a form of electromagnetic radiation, and focus it onto the tiny molecules to be detected. To facilitate the low-cost and pervasive integration in the future sensing devices, Gemini is introducing a novel material platform for the nano antennas, where only silicon and germanium are employed. These two materials are fully compatible with the mainstream microelectronic industry, but have not been used for nano antennas so far. More than 15 scientists from four European institutions, including many young researchers and PhD students, join their efforts within the Gemini team for the common goal of new sensor development. Each of them brings specific knowledge and capabilities to the project. The research team at the Physics Department and the LNES Center at Politecnico di Milano in Italy focuses its research on the material optimization and on the numerical analysis of the nano antennas. Silicon wafers from the microelectronic industry are covered by a thin layer of germanium with optimized properties to be used for the realization of the nano antennas. Advanced computational techniques are employed to design the nano antennas before fabrication. The James Watt Nanofabrication Center at the University of Glasgow in the UK uses the same techniques employed for the fabrication of microprocessors to produce nano antennas and infrared detectors. The electromagnetic designs and the materials from Milan are thus turned into sensors that are able to detect specific molecules. The research team at the Sapienza University of Rome in Italy takes care of the experimental characterization of the devices fabricated in Glasgow, specifically employing infrared light to test their sensitivity in the detection of important molecules such as explosives and DNA. Finally, the research team at the University of Konstanz in Germany is able to follow in real time the current oscillations in the nano antennas thanks to the generation and control of ultra-fast laser pulses in the infrared region. Such pulses are used to capture snapshots of the antenna fields and can also be employed to turn on and off the antennas by optical means. Gemini is aiming to demonstrate silicon chip molecular sensors that one day could be in everyone's mobile phones, monitoring your health and whether you are in a safe environment. Rather than calling a doctor when you feel unwell, future healthcare may phone you when the sensors in your phone indicates that you need to see a doctor. Such point-of-care healthcare has the aim of detecting diseases at the earliest stage where medicine has the highest chance of delivering a positive outcome. Industries and governmental agencies active in the field of microelectronics, photonics, healthcare, safety, and security will receive reports on the Gemini results, which will also be published with the open access to the public. The funding from the European Union allows Gemini to pursue its ambitious goals and contribute to making sensing technologies more effective, specific, and safer for the benefit of mankind.